All right, good morning. We're gonna be doing week two, day two. So grab some medium heavy weights if you have them. We're gonna get started. So light jog in place here. Light on the toes, just warming up that body. Kind of roll the shoulders back in now. Hi, Alice. All right, start doing those jump ropes right here. A couple deep breaths. I know we need those these days. We survived week one, maybe barely. All right, jumping jacks right here. Gonna go up and down. Low impact version, if this is a no-go, you can tap right here. Couple more deep breaths, right? Three more. Now back into that jump rope. Heel digs right here, march it out. Take it down. Just a quick little warm-up to get that body moving. All right, open it up nice and wide, or take it side to side. Just warming up those inner thighs and those hip flexors. Hold it to the right, hold it to the left. Last time. All right, now take it down to the floor. Nice little straddle stretch here. Take it to the right, middle, all the way over to the left. Back to the middle, heels in, toes out, drop that booty, sink it down. All right, hands on those knees, roll it up. Arch it down, one more. Roll it down, arch it up. Now heel toe those feet together. Arm circles here. Now take it forward. We don't want any crunchy shoulders, right? Shake it out. Let's get those quads real quick. Watches are started. Body is moving. Gonna get that coffee going in just a second. All right, grab those weights. Have them nearby, have your mat nearby. We're gonna get this party started. Let me start that timer. And we are on, my friends. I thought about doing a power 45 today, but I didn't. 10 seconds, we're gonna do four toe taps into four jumping jacks, okay? So three, two, and one. So it's four, three, two, one, four, three, two, one. Quick, 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 quick. Up, 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 up. Good. I lost count. Ten seconds, actually three, two, and one. So now for these prisoner get-ups, what you're gonna do, you're gonna take it down, hands behind the head. Down, down, up, up. Okay, so give yourself some space, lowering it down. There you go, my friend, sinking it down. 10 seconds. You're gonna grab your weights after this. All right, grab your weights. You're gonna stick it to the right. So, right side, up. Right side, up, okay? So every time you hold it center, you're gonna pause and give me a little curl, okay? Sinking it down here. 5 seconds. All right, switching legs. So now that left leg is gonna lead and curl with that drive. So this is round one. We've got those prisoner, those quick feet with the jacks, prisoner get-ups, and lateral lunges, okay? You got 10 seconds, my friends. Almost there. And one, so quick break. I'm gonna see if anybody else is trying to join. All right, I think we're, oh, Lori, she's, I think she's just gonna watch us. All right, ready? Back on with those quick feet. Three, two, and one. So one, two, three, four, jerk. Two, three, four. Quick feet. Jerk for four. Good job, my friends. If you've got music on, you can go to your beat. 10 seconds. Take it down, down, up, up. Good. If that hurts those knees, you can just stand and just do a regular squat, okay? 10 seconds, we're gonna grab those weights and go into that lateral lunge with that knee drive. Last one. All right, get up, grab those weights right here. Take it to that right side, my friend. All the way up. Oh, not all the way up, that's an option. We're coming here, unless you want it all the way. You can save those shoulders for later. There's plenty. Almost there, friends, 5 seconds. All right, switching sides for me. So getting all the way down, sticking out those hips. Drive it up and pause. If your balance isn't quite there here, you can just tap. Otherwise, try, hold it low. Almost there, my friends. You got 10 seconds on this one. Sink it low. Drive it up. 3, 2, and 1. Good job, my friends. One more time. Anybody else trying to get in? I think we're good. Good morning now, Lori. All right, 3, 2, and 1. Let me see those quick feet. Quick feet for 4, jumping jacks for 4. There you go. Quick, 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 quick. High, high, high. Ten more seconds here. Take those heels in, whip those arms, and make sure you're light on those feet. All right, my friends, you ready for it? Hands behind that head. Take it down, down, up. Kind of a functional movement, right? Getting down on all knees and having to get back up. Hopefully you're not under arrest, prisoner style. I envision us at the soccer field trying to get up off the grass. All right, you're almost there. 3, 2, and 1. Grab those weights. Now stepping over to that right side, holding, and either just tapping, holding, curling, and other option if you really want it, all the way up. You can also just tap the floor. Less than 10, my friends. Last little push here, and let's take it to the other side. So now, step and jump. So when you're here, every time you step, make sure you shift those hips back, come up into it, okay? You don't want that left knee to come over those left toes. Abs are tight, chest is lifting. You're almost there. Hold on to it, 10 more seconds. Sink it down. Drive it up. Power off that left leg as you drive it. Last set here in 3, 2, and 1. So you're gonna keep your weights for the next set. You're gonna need 1 for A, and then we're gonna go into a deadlift with a row, and then go into a static bridge with a skull crusher. So have those weights nearby. Goblet squat, you're gonna hold your kettlebell like this. You ready? 3, 2, and 1. All the way down, all the way up here. So this is where you can go heavier if you have a heavier one, holding that to the chest, sinking it down. My feet are wide, my toes are pointed out. Get as low as you can. Come up and squeeze at the top. You know the kind of squeeze that I want. You want those cheekers to pinch so tight at the top. All right, go ahead, grab your other weight. We're gonna go into a deadlift with a row. So for this, you wanna reach for those toes, and then when you come up, pull into that row and back into that deadlift. So all the way down, row, and pull it up. So you're gonna hold that flat back as you row before you release that deadlift, okay? All the way down.
Now, next one, we're gonna do a bridge on the wall or the ground. You decide, okay? So if you wanna do your bridge on the floor, you're just here doing your chest fly. Otherwise, take it into an elevated bridge with that chest fly. Everything up, everything down. Good. A few more, then we're gonna ditch that one weight, hold the bridge, and go into a skull crusher, ready? And switching it here. So, hips are gonna come high, hands are gonna come right above the chest. You're gonna bend the hands towards the forehead, reach the hands overhead, back to center, overhead. So down, overhead, all the way extended. Hips stay lifted, push through those glutes and heels. Hamstrings totally fired up right here. Almost there. All right, resting that out. So, back up. We're gonna go from goblet squat, deadlift row, down to the floor for that chest fly with the bridge, and then that bridge with a skull crusher. Ready? Holding on to that weight. Let's get low and squeeze it up here. I got more cardio coming your way, so if you, that heart rate's dropping a little bit, pick up that pace for those squats. I've only had one sip of coffee, so this is my pace right now. 10 more seconds. Sinking it down. Getting ready to pick up that other weight in 3, 2, and 1. Grab that other weight for me. Taking it down into that deadlift. Hold it down. Give me that row. Come out of that deadlift. Okay? So as you're here, reach towards those toes. Get a nice flat back. Give me that row. All the way up. So listen to your hamstrings and that low back. How low you go is gonna depend a lot on your range of motion, your flexibility, and your strength of that core. Last one. All right, drop it down. Coming into that bridge, you can either do the bridge on the floor with no weights, or if you want, you have your weights, okay? Or if you want even more, you can take it into an elevated bridge, which I prefer. Lower and lift everything at the same time here. 5 seconds. All right, hold it, hold it, hold it. If you're on the floor, you're still gonna hold your bridge out of that chest. Curl, extend, stack, release. Curl, extend. Good. If you have your 15s, you can try this, but if you have a shoulder that's even just a little bit sensitive, or a funny elbow, be careful. 5 seconds here, hold it, squeeze it higher. 3, 2, and 1. All right, round two done. I'm gonna do that all again, one more time. So if you need heavier weights, grab them. If you need lighter weights, grab them. Lori, are you just watching us? I love it. All right, ready? Grab those weights, let's go. Deadlift to that row. So what I'm doing is I'm going as far as my deadlift feels good, coming up a little bit, going into that row, and finishing it up. So if your deadlift is just right here, perfect. You don't have to go very far. Just listen to that body. If anything ever starts to pull or pinch, back off. Looking good, my friends. We're gonna be so swole after this quarantine. Almost there. All right, let's switch it there. Coming down onto, oh, we forgot our goblet squat. Ay, 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 get it together. All the way wide, sinking it down. All right, switching it there, come down to the ground. Give me that bridge with that chest fly. Elevated or on the floor, whatever feels good for you. So with those elbows, they're opening up to the sides and the palms of those hands are squeezing as well. Okay, almost there. All right, ditch that one leg here. You're gonna take it, hold that bridge, curl, extend, all the way up. Really accentuating that squeeze of those hips at the top, getting into the backs of those arms. Big breath out, big squeeze up. Less than 10 seconds here, ladies. Hips a little higher, weights extending all the way. 3, 2, and 1. Go ahead, drop that down. All right, we're gonna keep our weights for these next ones. You may need an extra set that's a little bit lighter, okay? I'm gonna open up my window here. 5 seconds, we're gonna start on the ground with that weight. Can you see me? So grabbing onto that weight, legs are long. You're going to crunch and alternate, tapping that foot, okay? So I have my 12 pounder and I'm just alternating that here. Good. Big squeeze at the top, my friends, keep going. You're almost there. 3, 2, and 1. Now you can use those weights if you want, because we're coming onto all fours here. And we're gonna do a tricep dip with a tap. Tricep dip, tap. So that booty is gonna lower to the floor. You're gonna push away and tap. Getting those back to those arms. Hey, yesterday was gorgeous weather. We're getting ready for those tank tops. You're almost there. 3, 2, and 1. I'm gonna grab my 8s for this warrior 3. It takes a while to get there, I know it. Find that balance, hover. We're gonna go into tricep kickbacks on that right side. So find your balance. If you have to hold on to something, you can. And then when we switch legs, you'll switch arms. Good, core is tight, hold it down. Woo, if I can find my balance. 3, 2, and switching sides. So warrior 3 here, tap that toe. Find that hinge, give me those kickbacks. You can do this without any weights and just hold the arms up and give me a little pulse. Again, just squeezing your shoulder blades together the whole time and you'll get something out of that. Less than 10 seconds. Find one spot on the floor, that always helps. 3, 2, and 1. All right, quick break here. Drink your coffee if you got it. Alright, less than 10. We doing good? 3, 2, and 1. Grab that weight. Down and up. Overhead reach. Alternate tapping the plate. Be mindful of that low back. YouTube. Oh, hold it, less than 10. up. All right, so back down we go. Getting into that ready position for those. Crunch and reach. Three, two, and one. So legs are planted, hands are overhead, and we're reaching one at a time here. Oh, I grabbed my eight. Feels a little different. Big breath in at the top, out as you reach. 10 seconds, my friends. Finishing it strong in three, two, and one. So you're either in that bridge doing your tricep dips, or you're dipping and tapping. Palms are planted, fingers are pointing towards those heels. Tap and cross. 5 seconds, ladies. Finish it strong. All right, girls. See if I can. I'm gonna hold it like this. I'm gonna reach down and bring it up. Pivot and bring it up. If you have lighter weights, if you're using your eights, you can use both. See how that feels? To kind of hold them together and bring it up. Reverse fly in three, two, and one. So tuck in those hips. Everything's coming out here. So with this, you want to make sure you have a soft bend in those elbows. Hands are coming out to the side. Elbows are reaching high. Form is looking good. I just want you to think about that core. Okay, zip up those abs. And take it into that wood chopper other side. If you feel like you didn't get enough reps, you could try to alternate. Again, you can have both weights. You can have one weight. Listen to your body, but you want to feel that diagonal at the top. Pivot down below. Up and low. 5 more seconds on this side. Grabbing onto both of those weights, we're going to step it back into our lunge, back, up, switching legs, back, up, so sink it down, switching legs, at that top, with that knee drive. Alright, rest it out. So, which upper right, fly, which upper left. Decide what feels good with the weights that you have. Which upper on that opposite side, ready? And let's go. So pivot high, pivot low. I'm gonna hold on to my weight, and looking over, and down. A little different than how to do it with a bungee. Drop the weight at any time. Grab something lighter. We'll hold on to that heavier weight. 5 seconds. All right, both weights go in. Exhale at the top of that, my friend. Back, up, switch legs, back, alternating here. Finish out, last one on that left side. And rest it out. Okay, one more set of those, we're gonna go with some burpees and some more cardio. So, get ready for it. Three, two. All right, foot tap, let's go. Bottom, feel those hips swivel up to the top. Pivot and drive. That low back should be engaged and fired up. And switching it, grab both. Reverse fly here. Slight hinge in those hips. Squeeze. If that's too much, you can go one at a time. Or get those weights all together. You decide here, my friends. Stay with me. If you got those heavier 12s or 15s, you might be alternating. I feel like 5 minutes are almost perfect for this. All right, switching it there. Ditch one weight if you need to. Taking into that wood chopper. Big breath in. Big breath out. Pivot into that movement for me. Cut across that body. Almost there, my friends. 5 seconds. We're going to pick up that other weight. All right, let's go. Lunging right here. So the quicker you go here, the more that heart rate will get up. The heavier your weights are, the more that heart rate will get up. So do what you feel is good for your body. If you're happy right here, stay there. Don't worry about that last little power set. Push through. 10 seconds. Finishing it out. 3, 2, and 1. All right, so. We're gonna do a similar lunge. We're gonna hold it wide. And go under curls right, curls left. And we're gonna do single leg burpees and the whole squats and serving platters. So you're gonna need both weights the whole time. So stepping it wide, gonna step it to the right, curl, back up, but you're not gonna move that foot, okay? Curl at the bottom. After this one, we're doing single leg burpees with a Spider-Man push up to the right side. So get ready, you can either keep those weights or ditch them. All right, so here you go, single leg burpee. You're gonna hover that right foot, okay? If this is too advanced, you can always keep that foot down as you pop back. A little bit of toe support, but try to attempt it covered, okay? Almost there. All right, my friends, switching it there. Grab those weights. Hold that squat low, serve that platter. If you have a 12 or 15, you might just want to grab one. Hold it low. Now that I'm reading the first exercise, you're supposed to alternate that lunge with this curl. We'll get there. Hold it low. All right. Single leg burpee, other side. So now, that left foot hovers into that right. That's your lead leg right here. Pop it down. Spider-Man push-up if you have it. All the way up, find that balance. You can always drop that toe, get a little bit of support if you need it. You can always drop to those knees if you need it. Last one. All right. So this round, we're gonna hold the left side, and for the third side, we'll alternate, okay? All right, roll that out. 3, 2, and 1. So stepping to the left. Curl, weights. Good, my friends, good. 10 seconds. Getting ready for that single leg burpee on that right side in 3, 2, and 1. So taking it down. Option, Spider-Man, whatever you gotta do. You don't have to use the weights for that. You can go wide in that push-up. You can tap that toe down, but try to do at least that single leg burpee, wrapping that ankle, foot around that ankle for me. Give me one more. All right, grabbing onto those weights or weight. Wide, serve that platter. So we usually do these on the GTS, but now we just have that weight close to that rib cage. Open it straight out. Big breath as it comes out. You're doing good, my friends. Less than 10. All right, single leg burpees on the side. Down you go. We never do single leg burpees. It's good for you. Let's see it. You're on. Move. Up we go. I don't think I got any push-ups left. You're welcome if I nominated you for the C10 Do 10. Thanks, Alice. I love yours. Suck your tongue out at me at the end. All right, rest it up. One more time. And then we've got some abs coming at you. I don't know. I thought it'd be more cardio than it is. So sorry if your heart rate's not up. Mine's at 145, so I'm feeling it. All right, let's go. We're gonna alternate this time. I feel better anyways. I should have my 12s. Almost there. Keep going, ladies. All right, switching it there. Single leg burpee here. So drop it down, back. Push up, okay. If you need to, you can add that Spider-Man. Add that toe tap if you have to at the top like I am. Finish it out 5 seconds. Get ready for that squat with the serve the platter. All right, there it is. Take it wide. Hips tucked under. Either both weights or one. You decide. Sink it down a little lower. Serve it out right here. There you go. 10 seconds. Last burpee coming at you. All right, last burpee, let's go. Drop it down, my friends. You got this. Let's finish it strong. Down, back. Option for that Spider-Man. I'm seeing why we never do single leg burpees. So grateful for not doing a power 45. 3, 2, and 1. Alright, so we're done with that set. You're gonna need, I'm gonna stick with my 8. That's what's feeling good. We're gonna take it into a marching. So you're gonna come here and here. So that's gonna sweep over that head and tuck it in. Ready? And let's go. So weights up, you tap it side. And then you drive. Okay? So you're drawing a little rainbow with your hands. And it's almost like a curtsy, but unintentional. That's not the goal. The goal is to get that crunch in those obliques. All right, switch sides. So if all goes well, my friends, this will be on YouTube. I already have it written out. So now that you know the moves, you can go ahead and repeat this one and press play whenever you want. 10 seconds. You can even do these without weights. And just really think about that elbow squeezing. All right, bring it down to the floor. You're gonna need those weights. Light weights, okay? Light weights. Hold it, you're open, close. If your upper body says no thank you, you can just hold a little pulse here. My shoulders say no thank you. So you can also hold it back and do invisible weights. And you're gonna turn towards the hand that's opening. All right, so now, sitting back, hot lava. Draw that invisible rainbow here. Again, if those hip flexors say no thank you, you can bend those knees. The goal here is to get into that core. There we go, my friends. Stay with me, stay with me. 5 more seconds. One. All right. So grabbing that single weight, we're back up for that marching oblique crunch. Tammy, you're making me seasick. What are you doing? So overhead, back. Again, you can do these without weights. Maybe have a light kettlebell, that works too, or medicine ball. Got my first cup of coffee in me. Fine, I'm ready for the rest of the day. Whatever the day might throw at me. All right, switch sides right there. Draw that rainbow. Tap. Cup all the way down. Up. Little balance, little coordination, I know. Again, you can ditch those weights if you need to. Just grip that elbow high to that knee. 3, 2, and 1. So bring it down. So not engaged here. Engage, hold it, proud chest. You're either lifting and looking towards that hand with the weight, or ditch the weight and twist. Hold it back, core is tight. Almost there, my friends. Ready for that hot lava? All right, hot lava it is. So you can draw that rainbow up and over. Almost there, my friends. If that hurts your hip flexors, you can always come into a reverse crunch as well. So you listen to that body and you can adjust as you need to. Last one. All right, last set. We're gonna do those marching obliques and you're done, okay? And run a lot of cardio, sorry. Sometimes you just gotta do strength, right? All right, tapping it over. Let's go. The good thing about strength training is when you fire up those muscles, your metabolism's gonna be burning all day long. When you do too much cardio, and then you hit that anaerobic where it starts eating into your muscle, you wanna make sure you're building that muscle up. Ah, lordy. 3, 2, and 1. So other side, last set of these. Take it down. Find that balance and that squeeze.
Squeeze.
Elbow to knee. Intentional. Squeeze right at the top of that. 3, 2, And one, down to the floor we go for the last time. Again, you can have your weights or not, but I want you leaning back with that chest back and a back flat. Twisting here. If the arms are done, you can make this a Russian twist and still get something out of it. I just want you to focus on those obliques. Woo! Three, two, and one. So either hot lava or reverse crunch. You're gonna draw in that rainbow over the corner, okay? Or take it down into that reverse crunch. You choose either one. We're gonna hit those lower abs. Done. Go ahead and stretch it out and get ready to start your day and have a fantastic rest of your week.